Welcome to Hibiscus Petroleum's Financial Results Webcast. This webcast presents an overview of the results reported as part of our quarterly financial report for the three-month period ended 30th June 2023 and released earlier today. This webcast has been prepared by Hibiscus Petroleum Berhad or the company solely for general information purposes and shall at all times be heard and or viewed together with the full quarterly report for the same period that has been made available or published by the company on its website. This webcast may contain forward-looking statements, which are based on current expectations, beliefs, and projections about future events or matters. By listening to and or viewing the webcast, you agree to the limitations and notifications set out in the disclaimer section of this webcast. Our presentation today is split into three parts. Part 1 of our presentation presents our key messages and highlights for this quarter, which will be presented by Pascal Hoss, CEO of Hibiscus Oil & Gas Malaysia Limited, a wholly owned subsidiary of the group. Part 2 covers the group's quarterly operational and financial updates and will be presented by our VP of Economics and Business Planning, Deepak Thakur, and our Chief Financial Officer, Yip Chi Yong, or CY. Guidance on our offtake schedule and gas sales, together with an update on our oil and gas reserves and resources, will be presented by Deepak Thakur in Part 3. Should you have any queries, you may contact our Investor Relations team headed by Lily Ling, our VP of Corporate Development, via the email address provided at the end of this presentation. Now, over to Pascal.
Hello, I am Pascal Hoss, CEO of Hibiscus Oil & Gas Malaysia Limited, or HML, and here are our key messages for the current quarter. Continued strong oil and gas prices have positively affected the group from a financial results perspective. In the current quarter, we sold approximately 1 million barrels of oil and condensate. Gas was also sold, which amounted to 0.7 million barrels of oil equivalent, or BOE. For financial year 2023, we sold an aggregate of 7.1 million barrels of oil equivalent, comprising a total of 4.5 million barrels of oil and condensate and 2.6 million barrels of oil equivalent of gas. Going forward, the group's target for financial year 2024 is to sell approximately 7.5 to 7.8 million barrels of oil equivalent of oil, condensate, and gas. In the current quarter, our average net oil, condensate, and gas production exceeded 19,000 barrels of oil equivalent per day, with Peninsula Hibiscus Group assets delivering 64% of this production. Financial year 2023 earnings before interest, taxes, depreciation, and amortization, or EBITDA, and profit after taxation, or PAT, stood at 1.3 billion ringgit and 400.5 million ringgit, respectively. The group's revenue for financial year 2023 exceeded the 2 billion ringgit mark for the first time at 2.3 billion ringgit. For a second consecutive year, the group exceeded the 1 billion ringgit mark in terms of EBITDA attainment. In the current quarter, we delivered an EBITDA of 326.5 million ringgit and a PAT of 123.3 million ringgit. This represents an increase of 66% for EBITDA and 19% for PAT compared against the normalized EBITDA and normalized PAT recorded in the financial year ended 30th June 2022. These normalized results in financial year 2022 were arrived at after excluding the negative goodwill of 317.3 million ringgit, which was recognized upon completing the acquisition of the Peninsula Hibiscus Group's assets from Repsol Exploration SA in January 2022. In the United Kingdom, the Teal West Development Environmental Statement was approved by the UK regulatory authorities on 7 July 2023. The North Sea Transition Authority subsequently approved the Field Development Plan on 1st August 2023 and issued Anasaria Hibiscus UK a production consent for Teal West. The drilling of the initial development well is planned to commence in the middle of calendar year 2024, and a non-binding letter of intent for securing a drilling rig has been executed. First oil from the development is expected in late calendar year 2024 or early calendar year 2025. The continued consistent financial performance of the group has allowed us to reward loyal shareholders. As previously disclosed, based on the present favorable market outlook and subject to the matters reflected in our dividend policy, the group is aiming to declare a minimum total dividend per share of 2.5 sen over the course of financial year 2023. Of this amount, a third interim single-tier dividend of 0.5 sen has been declared on 24 May 2023, bringing the total dividends declared to 2 sen per share. As detailed in a separate announcement on 23rd August 2023, we propose to undertake a consolidation of every 5 existing Hibiscus Petroleum shares into 2 consolidated shares. The rationale for the proposed share consolidation is to reduce the volatility of our share price and thereby create a more stable trading environment for our shares. It is also expected to increase market interest of our shares to a wider pool of investors seeking share price stability and longer-term growth, as well as institutional investors and investment funds whose investment guidelines currently limit trading in securities which are priced below a prescribed floor. Upon completion of the proposed share consolidation, our issued share capital shall remain the same. Further, there shall be no change in the percentage of equity interest and market value of shares held by shareholders other than non-material changes due to rounding and the disregard of fractional entitlements. Overall, we are pleased with the progress and performance of the group. That's all from me. Now on to Deepak for the operational updates.
Hello, I'm Deepak Thakur, VP of Economics and Business Planning. Let me bring you through an overview of this quarter's operational highlights. This table shows the operational performance of our North Sabah, Anasuya Cluster, and Peninsula Hibiscus Group assets for the current quarter ended 30th of June 2023. Focusing on the North Sabah asset, the production facilities recorded an average uptime of 94%, similar to that delivered for the preceding quarter. Average oil production of 4,465 barrels per day was lower when compared to the preceding quarter due to the commencement of planned maintenance activities and higher plant deferment. Approximately 350,000 barrels of oil net to Sea Hibiscus was sold at an average oil price of $82.77 per barrel in the current quarter, almost equivalent to the preceding quarter's realized average oil price of $83.02. Average production OPEX stood at $24.68 per barrel. Net OPEX per barrel, calculated by taking net production and net development OPEX and dividing it by net oil production, was $39.83 per barrel. Over at Anasuya, the average uptime of 97% was higher than the preceding quarter, while average daily oil equivalent production rate achieved of 2,489 barrels of oil equivalent per day was lower. Production in the current quarter was lower, primarily due to the shut-in of Gilmore P5 well since May 2023, caused by a hydraulic supply issue to the subsurface safety valve. One crude oil offtake was conducted at Anasuya during the current quarter, in which approximately 193,000 barrels of oil net to Anasuya Hibiscus UK was sold at an average realized oil price of $74.73 per barrel. Average production OPEX per BOE achieved in the Anasuya cluster for the current quarter of $19.08 was lower than that achieved in the previous quarter. Moving to the Peninsula Hibiscus Group assets, these include the 2012 Kinabalu Oil PSC, PM3CA PSC, PM305 PSC, PM314 PSC, and Block 46 PSC. It should be noted that the Kinabalu and PM3CA assets are the largest contributors to the Peninsula Hibiscus Group's performance. On a combined basis, the Peninsula Hibiscus Group assets recorded an uptime of 87%, an average net oil and condensate production rate of 6,128 barrels per day. Average gas production rate stood at 6,171 BOE per day. Approximately 484,000 barrels of oil and condensate were sold, while a total of about 4,300 million standard cubic feet of gas were sold. Average production OPEX stood at $12.18 per BOE, while net OPEX was $24.86 per BOE. Focusing on the Kinabalu asset, average net oil production in the current quarter fell compared to the preceding quarter due to unavailability of the high-pressure gas compressor, resulting in insufficient gas lift supply to the oil wells. This also affected its uptime, which came in at 71%. The compressor was rectified in mid-July 2023. Kinabalu's average net oil production of 2,458 barrels per day accounted for roughly 40% of Peninsula Hibiscus Group's total average net oil and condensate production of 6,128 barrels per day. One crude oil offtake was conducted in the current quarter with 200,000 barrels of oil sold, representing 41% of Peninsula Hibiscus Group's total oil and condensate sold of 484,000 barrels. At PM3CA, both average gross oil and condensate production as well as gas production were higher in the current quarter due to successful well work activities in PM3 South and stable oil production from the H4 reservoirs through optimized water injection. Average uptime was higher at 96%. PM3CA's average net oil production of 3,380 barrels per day accounted for approximately 55% of Peninsula Hibiscus Group's total average net oil and condensate production of 6,128 barrels per day. Average net gas sales production decreased to 6,171 BOE per day in the current quarter and accounts for all of Peninsula Hibiscus Group's gas production. Approximately 277,000 barrels of oil were sold, representing 57% of Peninsula Hibiscus Group's total oil and condensate sold of 484,000 barrels, while a total of about 4,300 million standard cubic feet of gas was sold. CY will now go over the financial updates.
Hi, I'm CY, the Chief Financial Officer of Hibiscus Petroleum Group. As we have often reiterated in the past, the group places strong emphasis on careful management of costs and the efficient delivery of production enhancement projects. This represents a critical part of our strategy of maintaining a low unit production cost structure in all of our producing oil and gas assets. In addition, we try to time the implementation of maintenance activities to ensure that positive cash flows are consistently delivered. The group operates or jointly operates its main producing assets. This is a key enabler in allowing us to influence the timing of the implementation of operational activities, supporting our ability to manage the phasing of expenditure. The chart on the far left on this slide shows the quarterly weighted average realized prices of both oil and condensate offtakes and gas sales, unit production costs, and earnings before interest, taxes, depreciation and amortization, or EBITDA, margins over the last 6 quarters for the Peninsula Hibiscus Group assets. The next two charts show the quarterly average realized oil prices, unit production costs, and EBITDA margins for both North Sabah and the Anak Suria cluster over the last 10 quarters. As clearly illustrated in the charts, the average unit production cost for the Peninsula Hibiscus Group assets, North Sabah and the Anak Suria cluster have been consistently well below the average realized prices achieved in the respective quarters, delivering sustained positive cash flows. Management's focus remains on continuing this trend of overall performance. I would like to highlight that the group's revenue is almost fully transacted in US dollars, while costs are mainly denominated in the local currencies of the jurisdictions in which the operating assets are located, namely the Malaysian ringgit in Malaysia and the British pound in the UK. In addition to that, some costs are denominated in US dollars. Accordingly, a healthy US dollar bodes well for the group and positively impacts our cash flow and financial performance. I will now take you through a summary of the financial highlights for the current financial quarter. The group recorded relatively strong sales volume in the current quarter. We sold approximately 1 million barrels of crude oil and 0.7 million barrels of oil equivalent gas. Revenue generated was 503.6 million ringgit. The sale of oil and condensate contributed 389.4 million ringgit to total revenue, while contribution from the sale of gas was 110.1 million ringgit. During the current quarter, the group also recognized a one-off gain which arose from the reversal of an over-provision of penalties relating to previously unpaid state sales tax imposed by the Sabah state government on C. Hibiscus and HML. As of 30th June 2022, the group had accrued for penalties imposed by the Sabah state government for unpaid state sales tax up to 30th June 2022, amounting to 38.2 million ringgit. This amount comprised 33.7 million ringgit attributable to North Sabah and 4.5 million ringgit was accrued for Kinabalu. C. Hibiscus, which holds 50% participating interest in North Sabah, NHML, which holds 60% participating interest in Kinabalu, were able to achieve mutual agreements with the Sabah state government to settle the penalties imposed at reduced amounts of 8.3 million ringgit and 0.9 million ringgit respectively. Accordingly, in the current quarter, North Sabah and Kinabalu reversed the overprovision of these penalties, amounting to 25.4 million ringgit and 3.6 million ringgit respectively. This reversal, together with the strong sales volume, have enabled the group to record an EBITDA of 326.5 million ringgit. The resulting EBITDA margin over revenue was 65%. I will now proceed to highlight the performance of the group's oil and gas producing assets now. Firstly, our Peninsula Hibiscus Group assets. This group of assets have continued to contribute positively to the financial performance of the group. During the current quarter, this Peninsula Hibiscus Group assets contributed 290.3 million ringgit or 57.7% to the group's revenue, 188 million ringgit or 57.6% to the group's EBITDA, and 58.5 million ringgit or 47.4% to the group's PAT. The contribution from these two production sharing contracts in the Peninsula Hibiscus Group assets on the group's financial performance, namely the PM3 CAA PSC and the Kinabalu PSC, are as follows. PM3 CAA's operational performance in the current quarter was reasonably strong on the back of successful well work activities in the PM3 southern field and stable oil production from the H4 reservoirs through optimized water injection. A high average uptime of 96% was recorded. The PSC attained an average net oil equivalent production rate of 9,551 barrels of oil equivalent per day, while the production OPEX per barrel of oil equivalent of $11.41 reflected relatively low maintenance and production enhancement activities being performed in the current quarter. The PM3 CA PSC sold 277,000 barrels of oil and condensate at an average oil price of $86.18 per barrel and 713,000 barrels of oil equivalent gas in the current quarter. Oil and gas revenue generated amounted to 109.3 million ringgit and 102.7 million ringgit respectively. The favorable operating performance and fairly strong sales volume have enabled PM3 CAA to report high profitability margins. The gross profit and gross profit margin attained in the current quarter were 143.3 million ringgit and 67.6% respectively. The EBITDA for PM3 was 147.9 million ringgit, which resulted in an EBITDA margin of 69.8%. The second notable production sharing contract in the Peninsula Hibiscus Group assets is the Kinabalu PSC. This PSC sold 200,000 barrels of crude oil net to our group at an average oil price of $80.50 per barrel. Kinabalu achieved gross profit of 50 million ringgit and a relatively high gross profit margin of 66.7% in the current quarter. Operational performance in Kinabalu during the current quarter continued to be adversely impacted by the outages experienced with the high-pressure gas compressor that led to insufficient gas lift supply to the oil wells. This was rectified in mid-July 2023. Production was further impacted by a deferral in well intervention activities due to an unexpected platform crane failure experienced since April 2023, which prevented certain maintenance activities to be conducted. This crane failure is targeted to be resolved by September 2023. This resulted in a relatively lower net oil production rate of 2,458 barrels per day and higher production OPEX per barrel of $16.72. Kinabalu recorded an EBITDA of 29.2 million ringgit and an EBITDA margin over revenue of 75 million ringgit was 38.9%. I would like to highlight that while the Kinabalu PSC was in a taxable position in the current quarter, no provision for taxation was made as there were sufficient historical tax losses brought forward to completely offset such taxes payable under the Petroleum Income Tax Act 1967 or PITA. We now move to the North Sabah asset. This segment sold 351,000 barrels of crude oil, net to the group, and reported revenue and gross profit of 133.7 million ringgit and 71.6 million ringgit respectively. In the current quarter, North Sabah's operations were impacted by the planned calendar year 2023 major maintenance campaign and an ongoing well intervention campaign. The average production OPEX per barrel recorded was US$24.68, while the average net oil production rate was 4,465 barrels per day. North Sabah reported an EBITDA margin of 76.8 million ringgit and 57.4%, respectively, for the current quarter. The EBITDA attained was aided by the reversal of the over-provision of penalties related to unpaid Sabah state sales tax of 25.4 million ringgit, as highlighted earlier. From the United Kingdom segment, a net 193,000 barrels of crude oil were sold from the Anasira cluster at US$74.73 per barrel. Revenue generated from the sales of crude oil amounted to 68 million ringgit in the current quarter. In addition, gas sales delivered a revenue of 7.4 million ringgit. The Anasira cluster in the UK has experienced a considerable improvement in operational performance ever since the project to repair the riser that failed in May 2021 was completed in September 2022. During the current quarter, the asset achieved high average uptime and average daily oil equivalent production rate of 97% and 2,489 barrels of oil equivalent per day, respectively. Production OPEX per barrel of oil equivalent recorded in the current quarter was US$19.08. The UK segment's EBITDA for the current quarter was 52.4 million ringgit. The UK upstream oil and gas industry has been recently subjected to an additional 35% tax on UK oil and gas profits, in addition to the existing ring-fence corporation tax of 30% and supplementary charge of 10%, for a total of 75%, with the implementation of Energy Profits Levy, or EPL. It should be noted that we do not expect a significant income taxation liability arising from the EPL regime. Our intention remains to phase our UK capital expenditure program such that we optimise certain incentives offered as part of the EPL being imposed. It is also clear that the government's taxation policies are incentivising decarbonisation initiatives within the UK oil and gas sector, and this encourages us to identify further opportunities that will reduce our overall carbon footprint. Lastly, the group remains in a strong liquidity position. The continuous favourable operational performance and relatively strong oil, condensate and gas prices have resulted in positive cash flows being generated from our producing assets and contributing to a favourable net current assets position recorded as at 30th June 2023 amounting to 687.7 million ringgit. From a full financial year perspective, the group's revenue for the financial year ended 30th June 2023 exceeded the 2 billion ringgit mark for the first time, at 2.3 billion ringgit. Contribution from the Peninsula Hibiscus Group assets was instrumental to achieving this milestone, while the North Sabah and Anasuria cluster assets also continued to deliver strong performance. This financial year also marks the first year in which the group recorded a positive contribution from the Peninsula Hibiscus Group assets for a full 12-month period. On the back of such strong revenue levels, the group achieved EBITDA of 1.3 billion ringgit for the full financial year. This meant that for a second consecutive year, the group exceeded the 1 billion ringgit mark in terms of EBITDA attainment. I will now hand over back to Deepak, who will go over the offtake schedule and updated reserves and resources.
Hello again. This slide presents the group's oil and condensate offtakes and gas sales from our producing assets for the financial quarters ending 30th of September 2023 and 31st of December 2023. In summary, we estimate to sell a total of approximately 2.1 million barrels of oil equivalent and 1.9 million barrels of oil equivalent of oil, condensate and gas respectively net to the group. For the financial year ending 30th of June 2024, the group is targeting to sell a total of between approximately 7.5 to 7.8 million barrels of oil equivalent of oil, condensate and gas. The chart on this slide depicts our updated net oil and gas reserves and resources as at 1st July 2023 across all our assets. As part of the group's regular review of our reserves and resources, we undertook an independent assessment of the reserves of North Sabah with the engagement of RPS Energy Consultant Limited and an internal review of Anasuria and Teal West reserves and resources. The Anasuria 2P oil reserves were reduced to 16.6 million barrels, mainly due to the reduction in the 2P undeveloped reserves at the Gilmore and Teal fields. The Teal West 2C oil resource was reduced to 4.3 million barrels after remapping the structure with the new processed seismic data and having considered the planned timing of drilling a water injection well. However, following Teal West FDP approval and granting of the production consent, its 2C oil resource was reclassified as 2P oil reserves. Reserves for the other assets were derived by adjusting for the total net production from 1st January to 30th of June 2023 and any incremental 2P reserves from the new projects. As of 1st July 2023, our total net proven and probable, or 2P reserves, stood at 67 million barrels of oil equivalent, while total net 2C contingent oil resources stood at 60.6 million barrels. I will now hand over back to Andrew.
Thank you, Deepak. And that is all we have for this quarterly earnings webcast. Again, should you have any queries, you may contact our investor relations team via the email address shown on this slide. Thank you for tuning in.